Welcome to Sleep Talk with Dr. Dev and my assistant, Barley. Barley, we're on location today. How are you doing, buddy?
All right, Dr. Dev.
Today we're going to talk about medicinal cannabis. Medicinal cannabis has become quite a revolution in treating disease and well-being. I mean, cannabis has been around for thousands and thousands of years, and it's certainly over the last few decades we've realized that chemicals from the cannabis plant can be used in treating health and well-being. Now, many of you might think that medicinal cannabis is the same as recreational cannabis, but I can assure you it's very, very different. And for those that might have a stigma about recreational cannabis, then hopefully I can reassure you that we are using medicinal cannabis much more widely nowadays with enormous benefit to patients. Now, there's many chemicals that we can get from the cannabis plant, and these are called cannabinoids. The two most commonly talked about cannabinoids is cannabidiol, or CBD, or tetrahydrocannabinol, or THC. But there's lots of other cannabinoids that we'll be hearing more about as more and more research is done, such as CBN or CBG, and another set of chemicals called terpenes that give the aroma. Now, CBD and THC is predominantly what we find in medicinal cannabis, and both have quite different properties. There's many receptors in the human body, such as the central nervous system, or the bones, or the spleen, or the lymphatic system, where CBD and THC act upon. But CB1 receptor and CB2 receptor, where the CBD and the THC act upon, is mainly found in the central nervous system. And it's through these central nervous system effects that we have an improvement in anxiety, improvement in sleep, and reduced pain. When I see a patient who's been struggling with their sleep or have something called insomnia, there's a few things I really need to know about that sleep or lack of sleep. I need to know, obviously, if it's difficulty in getting to sleep, staying asleep, or early morning wakening, and obviously how much that impacts on the well-being in the day, particularly fatigue, tiredness, concentration, focus, and general mood. There's four quadrants, as I call it, of patients. The first group that I see very commonly is those with busy brains or a hyperdrive type of sleep, that flight, fright, and flight, and can't switch off, that cortisol flying around in the brain. And these patients are those with anxiety or mental health issues, PTSD, ADHD, bipolar. The second group of patients that I see commonly are the fragmented sleep. They just can't get to sleep and stay asleep, and it's very broken sleep. It's like chopping up their sleep, like chopping up a cucumber. It just really is not restorative. And this type of sleep is very common in those with chronic depression, neurodegenerative disorders such as Parkinson's disease, and also very common in dementia. The third group of patients that I see commonly are those with restless sleep, those who sleepwalk or have night terrors or nightmares or restless legs, or they can't get to sleep because they're out of sync with their sleep cycle, something called delayed sleep phase syndrome. These restless sleepers have terrible issues with regard to the sleep and fatigue and tiredness. And they're another big group that I see, particularly in the younger age group. And then there's the fourth group, the noisy sleepers. Those that snore a lot, have sleep apnea, or they stop breathing, but they may also have issues with hyperdrive sleep or fragmented sleep or restless sleep. Generally, when I'm considering medicinal cannabis in these patients, if you're a hyperdrive asleep, these groups do very well on CBD oil or cannabidiol. What CBD oil does, it just reduces that flight, fright and flight, and reduces that ready, steady, go feature of their sleep. Those who've got quite severe fragmented sleep, I do add on a little bit of THC or tetrahydrocannabinol to the CBD just to further consolidate that sleep. But the CBD is very important, again, to just improve that and settle that busy brain that they may also have. The third group, the restless sleepers, if there is anxiety that's driving the night terrors or the sleepwalking, then I do tend to start off with the CBD, But many with restless legs have chronic pain, and chronic pain is another very common issue with those who can't sleep. It doesn't go away when the sun goes down, and those patients will mind you very well with CBD with a little bit of THC. THC is very good for chronic pain, but if you've got the neuropathy pain like sciatica or shooting pain down the arms. So a combination of CBD and THC for those restless sleepers can work very well. And then the final group, the noisy sleepers, those who have sleep apnea still may have anxiety and just quite can't settle that brain down to get into the groove of sleep. And for those that are trying to get onto CPAP with the mask, it can be very difficult. So in those patients, I actually start off with CBD oil, get the hyperarousal state, the busy brain quieter, and then maybe a few weeks later, go onto the CPAP machine. And as a combination of treating the sleep apnea and the sleep disturbance, these patients do feel a lot better. And let's not forget, medicinal cannabis can also reduce the need of other sleeping tablets like benzodiazepines. And I've had a huge success in getting people off those drugs like temazepam, zopiclone, Stilnox. So there you go, that's medicinal cannabis in a nutshell. So we'll see you next time. Cheerio!